for the prayer by the Honorable Pancho of Bulacan.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Almighty God, we come to thee humbly asking for your guidance and enlightenment. May we be blessed with your holy presence that all that we will do and say will reflect thy will. We offer to you, dear God, our meeting today. Bless our institution, our leaders, members of this committee, our resource persons, guests, and all that will be affected by this activity. Send your Holy Spirit that we may be enlightened and nourished with fresh minds and open hearts. Show us the way to follow your will and that we find understanding and agreement in moments of discord. Thank you, dear Jesus, for this opportunity that we are gathered to serve and praise you. May your peace, grace, mercy, and perfect order be upon us all. Amen. Spirit.
For the national anthem. Please take your seats. We will now call the
yes. Mr. Chair, I move to dispense with the roll call.
Members present in today's hearing.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good afternoon. In today's meeting, we have the following members in attendance. Senior Deputy Speaker Aurelio Dong D. Gonzalez Jr. We also have the Vice Chairperson Janet E. Pimentel. Congressman Ricardo S. Cruz Jr. Congressman Raul Daniel Manuel. Congressman Ramon Rodrigo Gutierrez, Congressman Agustina Dominic C. Pancho. We also have a Congresswoman Antonieta Yudela, Congresswoman Margarita Ignacia Nograles, Congresswoman Franz L. Castro, Congresswoman Richelle Singson, and Congressman Joseph Stephen Carabs S. Patuano. Your honors.
Thank you very much, Committee Secretary. The committee has calendared today the continuing discussion on several measures, including House Resolution Number 230, entitled "The Resolution Condemning the Fake News Peddling and Baseless Red Tagging of Individuals, Groups, and Organizations by Sunshine Media Network International, thereby endangering their lives and democratic rights," and urging the National Telecommunications Commission to apprise the House of the status of complaints against SMNI pending before it, authored by the Honorable Representatives Franz Castro, Arlene Bosses, and Raul Daniel Manuel. House Resolution Number 1428, entitled "The Resolution Condemning the Fake News Peddling and Baseless Red Tagging and Grave Threats Against ACT Teachers Parties," Representative Franz Castro, by Rodrigo Roel Duterte and Sunshine Media Network International, and urging NTC to investigate The incident, in light of media and journalism standards and existing laws, authored by the Honorable Arlene Rosas, Raul Daniel Manuel, and Franz Castro. The privilege speech of Representative David J.J. Suarez on November 28, 2023, regarding the immediate investigation of the fake news peddling of SMNI against House Speaker Martin Romualdez and House Bill Number 9710, entitled An Act Revoking the Legislative Franchise Granted to Suarez-Sug Media Corporation, operating under business name Sunshine Media Network International, repealing for the purpose Republic Act Number 114422, entitled An Act Renewing for Another 25 Years the Franchise Granted to Suarez-Sug Media Corporation under Republic Act 8122. For several months now, this committee has conducted its inquiry about Suarez-Sug Media Corporation and its operations, leading to discoveries about its violations of Section 10, 11, 12, and 4 of its franchise agreement. The committee is also aware that concurrent with its investigation is a parallel inquiry being conducted by the Senate, which has shielded other various serious allegations against SMNI, including sexual abuses, human trafficking, labor exploitation, and other physical abuses. May mga paratang na ang mga empleyado ng SMNI ay nagtatrabaho sa stasyon sa umaga pero pinagpalimos gabi. Meron tigo na nagsabi, hindi siya binabayaran ng tamang sweldo ng SMNI at wala silang PhilHealth at SS benefits. These are very grave allegations which have very much concern among the members of this committee and the Filipino people. The committee is also aware of the Department of Justice decision to charge Pastor Apollo Quibuloy with sexual abuse of a minor in violation of Republic Act Number 7610 or the Anti-Child Abuse Law and qualified human trafficking and other acts of child abuse. Taken in totality, the members of this committee are very concerned about the findings made by the Senate and by the DOJ as they reveal heinous crimes committed by persons behind Suarez-Sug Corporation. Throughout these proceedings, we have consistently requested the presence of Suarez-Sug Corporation's current and past leadership, and to give them an opportunity to clarify and provide answers to the queries asked by the House members. We will once again give them that opportunity to air their side today. The Committee on Legislative Franchise, with its mandate, must ensure the privilege of the franchise given to those who have complied with our laws, and have worked for the good of the Filipino people. As always, it is common good that the committee continues to strive for in this process. Maraming salamat po. May I ask the committee secretary? Source persons, please. Can you please acknowledge the resource persons present? Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, and for the information of this body, we have the following resource persons in attendance. From the NTC, we have the Deputy Commissioner Alvin Blanco. From the Securities and Exchange Commission, we have Attorney Algin Lacanaria. From the MTRCB, we have Attorney Cesar Pareja. From KBP, we have Ms. Attorney Rudolph Hularbal. From the NTC COA, we have Mr. Job Aguirre and Ms. Mary Jane Sadang. From SMNI, we have Pastor Marlon Acobo, the Executive Pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ. KOGC, right. You are the executive pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ. Thank you. We also have the members of the board of SMNI, Ludovia Godoy, Ms. Cristina San Pedro, Ms. Loris Nepomuceno, Ms. Hannah Shane Sancho, and their legal counsel, Attorney Mark Tolentino and Attorney Rolex Suplico. We also have the executive staff of KOJC, Attorney Eunice Ambrosio, the president of SMNI, Dr. Marlon Rosete, and counsel of KOJC, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio. We also have the consultant, a consultant of SMNI in the person of Mr. Jay Sonsa. The honors.
The representative of Tingog Party, this Honorable Jude Asire. Welcome, sir, to the hearing. And of course, walking in is the hardworking and good-looking congressman of Quezon City, the Deputy Majority Leader, the Honorable Franz Pumarin. So now we now proceed.
Mr. Chair.
The Honorable Franz Castro is recognized, ma'am.
If I can remember, Mr. Chair, we asked to summon or invite Pastor Kibuloy. So what's the status of him?
Mr. Chair, I was going to raise that also. During the last hearing, February 7, if you will recall, most especially those who were present during that hearing, this committee issued a subpoena to Pastor Kibuloy because of his non-appearance on the several invitations that we sent him. And I can see that, again, Pastor Kibuloy is a no-show in this hearing. Now, it is very clear under the House rules, especially in rules of governing procedure on inquiries in aid of legislation, Section 11, the committee may punish any person for contempt by a majority of members present, specifically on Section A, refusal without legal excuse to obey summons, and Section E, acting in a disrespectful manner. In this case, although he is not present, but the fact that he has not been appearing in these hearings in this committee just shows that he has no respect for this committee. It just shows that he acts like God. He acts with impunity. He takes this hearing for granted. Ipinagwawalang balahala niya, importante ho siya dito. So in this case, Mr. Chair, kahit na hearing pa tayo ng 20 beses, kahit na 20 beses natin imbitahin si Pastor Kibuloy, it is very clear that he has no intention whatsoever of appearing in this committee. Therefore, Mr. Chair, under House rules, it is our obligation to show these people who take this committee for granted the sanctions that could be meted under our House rules. Therefore, Mr. Chair, I move to cite for contempt Pastor Kibuloy on the grounds which I have stated. So move, Mr. Chair.
There's a motion by the Honorable Pimentel.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, the Honorable.
With indulgence of the good Congressman Pimentel, with regards to this motion, I have nothing against it, but it's just proper, Mr. Chair, siguro na we might ask the representative of Kibuloy, then we will rule on that particular motion.
Okay. With the request of the Honorable Paduano, the Honorable Pimentel will defer and hold in abeyance.
I yield to the request.
Yes. And the Honorable Attorney Topacio, magandang hapon po sa inyo.
Magandang hapon po, Mr. Chair, Your Honors. May I be recognized, Your Honor?
Yes, you are.
Thank you, Your Honor. Your Honor, with respect to the motion and with all due respect, we believe we have provided legal justification for the non-presence of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy in our letter to the committee, Your Honor, wherein the gist of it states that based on the previous hearings of this honorable committee, we have an idea of the information being required, and we have stated in this letter, Your Honors, very respectfully, that Pastor Quiboloy for around 4 years now has had no hand whatsoever in the running of SMNI, whose franchise is under consideration, Your Honor. Instead, to show our good faith and our due respect to this honorable committee, and to show that we are not evading the subpoena, Your Honors, we have brought with us three persons who are in the best position, more than Pastor Quiboloy, and who have been the ones active since 2022 in the affairs of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, which are the current executive pastor of the KJOC and his top staff, Attorney Eunice Ambrosio and Maria Norfeli Marimon, Your Honors. So with respect to the kingdom, they are the ones who possess the necessary competence to answer whatever questions this honorable committee may throw at them, Your Honors.
Mr. Chair, we understand the explanation of Attorney Topacio, but the fact still remains that Pastor Quiboloy has not appeared in this committee. You are presenting actually three persons that you have just mentioned to explain whatever questions or whatever clarifications are needed. As you have stated, they are well versed with regards to the operations of Suarasug. But the matter at hand, Mr. Chair, I believe, still remains is the non-appearance of Pastor Quiboloy. Of course, Mr. Chair, we will entertain or we will ask questions to your substitute resource persons. But Mr. Chair, I still insist my motion, my earlier motion, I again reiterate, I move to cite for contempt Pastor Quiboloy, Mr. Chair.
Thank you very much, Honorable Pimentel. Attorney Topacio.
Your Honor, we will always submit to the discretion of the committee with just the very respectful and gentle reminder, Your Honors, that in the very recent case of Ong versus Senate Blue Ribbon Committee, the Supreme Court has ruled that before any person is held in contempt of the a House or any committee thereof, he must be given due process, meaning a chance to explain, Your Honor. We are just invoking this right on behalf of Pastor Quiboloy because our Constitution itself states that the rights of persons invited to congressional hearings should be respected, Your Honor. That is all that we ask, Your Honor, nothing else.
Thank you, Attorney Topacio. Just for the information of everyone, Pastor Quiboloy has been invited as far back as December. Several invitations has been given to him, and he has not appeared, which prompted the Honorable Pimentel to he filed a motion for him to for us to subpoena Pastor Quiboloy because of his non-appearance in previous hearings. So I think as far as due process is concerned, we have complied with this. Matter of fact, because of his absence, I'm so familiar already with Attorney Mark Tolentino. Okay? And I'm, of course, the idol of everyone, the guy that invented the rules of the House, the Honorable Rolex Suplico, who is also here, who I used to read in the newspapers when I was in elementary. Okay? And up to now, it's an honor to see him in our hearings. That's why ako po'y As far as pagiging due process, matter of fact po, eh, marami pong mga katanungan, marami pong hindi masagot, at lagi po na sabi hindi na kaya sagutin. No? And which really, I think, mahaba naman po yung proseso na binigay po namin para po sa kanyang pagpunta ko dito. At kami naman po ay kumbaga na-extend na po namin. As a matter of fact, eh, naubos na po lahat ng mga pwedeng maitanong. Dahil naitanong sa dami pong hearings na hinandak na po ng Committee Attorney Topacio. And this can be, I think, Attorney Suplico would attest to this. No? Na talagang we were very patient at lahat po ng pamamaraan ay binigay po namin sa kanila. So, maraming salamat, Attorney Topacio. Wala na po kayong imamanifest. May tanong lang po ko. Alam po, okay. Pwede po ba ako magtanong?
Of course, Your Honor, you're the chairman.
Siyempre. Kasi ho, pwede na ho namin yung subpoena February 20. No? At ito'y publicized naman. At bakit po sa March 11 lang po kayo nagpadala ng sulat? At nauna po ho ang media kasi tumatawag po sa akin ang media. At ang sabi ko sa kanila, hindi ko po pwede sigutin yan dahil wala po akong natanggap na sulat. True enough, sinek ko yung records, natanggap lang ko namin yung sulat nyo kahapon, okay. March 11. Tapos may amended letter at March 12 today, kumarap po yung isang abogado ninyo. So, bakit, why did it take you so long to write us that letter?
Kasi po, hindi po ako involved, Mr. Chair, doon sa previous mga hearings. So, nireview ko pa po yung video ng mga hearings para mapagtanto ko po kung ano yung mga maaring itanong based on the trend. At yun nga po, coupled with the fact that Pastor Kibuloy has been out of the day-to-day or even the general operations of SMNI or Swarasug, Your Honor, because he has decided to concentrate on purely spiritual matters, ay lugihan po kami. Yung unang liham po kasi, pasensya na po kayo, we meant no disrespect to the committee, Mr. Chair. Kanya lang, bago noong ibibigay na po namin dito, napansin po namin may typographical errors lang naman po, kaya ni-revise po namin.
Which was received today.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes.
Typographical errors lang po ang
so, kaming... So that's why the first letter we received March 11, the second letter we received today at the day of the hearing.
Opo, maybe. Yes. Pero it's basically the same, Your Honor. We did not want to spring any surprise. It's just a typographical error, Your Honor.
Thank you,
we apologize because of the a tight schedule of this representation. We profoundly apologize to the committee and to the chair.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Before I continue, the chair will recognize the Deputy Speaker, the Honorable David J.J. Suarez. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much.
The Honorable Franz Pumarin is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Address lang pong question kay Attorney Topacio. I'm quite baffled, no, dahil he mentioned that kaya hindi pupunta dahil wala siya dun sa day-to-day activity, yung pagpapatakbo ng SMNI, hindi niya alam. In fact, there are three resource speakers that can answer that. My main question lang here, kung gano'n man pala, may invitation siya, bakit ayaw niyang pumunta? Then, let him explain to us kung ano talaga ang role niya dun sa SMNI. And aside from that, probably there are still other questions that can be raised there. Yun lang naman ang quite baffling on my part na bakit ayaw niyang pumunta. Na kung confident naman siya na he has no idea how yung SMNI operates day-to-day basis. Yun lang po, Mr. Chairman.
May I respond, Mr. Chair? Actually po, huwag niyo na pong sisihin si Pastor. Ako na pong sisihin niyo, Honorable Franz Pumarin, sapagkat ako po yung nagpayo sa kanya. While the details of the advice may be covered by lawyer-client privilege, ako po yung sabi kay Pastor na since ang nakikita ko po sa trend ay tungkol naman sa alleged violations ng frankisa ng SMNI, ay since wala naman po kayong kinalaman at ang inyong titulo na honorary chairman ay purely honorific as the name suggests, sabi ko upang hindi naman Paipakita naman natin na ginagalang po natin yung proseso ng kagalang-galang na committee ito ay tayo na po magdala ng mga tao na maaaring makasagot dun sa mga yon. Ngayon po, I want to take this opportunity with the kind indulgence of my congressman in Parañaque, the chair. Kung mamarapatin niyo lamang naman po, kami po ay magalang na humihiling na baka naman po kagalang-galang na kinatawan na bigyan po na naman kami kahit konting panahon lang po na magpaliwanag at baka naman po makausap po rin siya at baka naman po makita niya na baka naman pwede siyang dumating sa susunod. Pagkakataon lamang po at rest assured that we will be prompt in our response to Mr. Chair and members of the Honorable Committee. In fact, I'm scheduled to meet with him tomorrow, Your Honors, if I may inform this Honorable Committee, and I will advise him accordingly. Honorable Pumarin, please.
Thank you, Attorney Tibasio. Mr. Chairman, just for the record, yes. Nakailan invitation na ba tayo kay Pastor?
Tatlo. Tatlong invitation na po tayo. Before we recognize the next interpreter, the chair recognizes the Honorable Arlene Rosas. Welcome, ma'am, to the committee hearing. And the who else is here? The Honorable Inodi is here. Welcome to the hearing.
Mr. Chair,
the Honorable Pimentel.
We are just prolonging this issue. We know very well that kahit na ano pang sabihin ni Attorney Topazio, he was hired by Pastor Kibuloy as a legal counsel. It's his job to delay this contempt. Alam naman natin, Attorney Topazio, kahit na sa'yo, naniniwala ba kayong sisipot si Pastor Kibuloy? These are just delaying tactics. Even though na mag-hearing na naman tayo next, iba na namang rason ng lila ibibigay. Mag-hearing na naman tayo ikapitong hearing, ibang rason na naman. When will this be concluded? As I've said, Mr. Chair, it is incumbent upon this committee. It is our obligation under the rules that we should cite him for contempt to compel him to appear in this committee, Mr. Chair. Again, on my second, actually on my third reiteration, Mr. Chair, my motion still stands.
Thank you. Just a point of clarification on the statements made by Attorney Topazio. By the way, congratulations on your movie.
Thank you, sir.
You mentioned that you're off to see The Good Pastor tomorrow.
Yes, Your Honor.
So that confirms that he's still in the Philippines.
Yes, of course, Your Honor. He's not going anywhere, Your Honor.
Oh, kasi may mga balita na nag-ibang bansa na daw siya.
Hindi po. Magpapakuha po ako ng litrato at ipa-viber ko po sa mga members ng committee.
I trust you, Attorney.
Thank you po. I appreciate that, sir.
Yun lang, I just wanted to reiterate, Mr. Chair, you know, we've been having this hearing since December of last year.
November
of last year. So, long playing album na po ito kasi November, December, January, February, March, I think. This can already be part of the Guinness Book of World Records as one of the longest hearings. This just goes to show the leniency and the patience the Committee on Franchise has afforded to SMNI, to Suarsug, when it comes to complying with requests that have been forwarded to you. So, on his proper time, Mr. Chair, I would second the motion of Congressman Pimentel.
Thank you, the Honorable
Mr. Chair.
The Honorable Karaps Paduano, then the Honorable Arlene.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
And the Honorable Franz Castro.
Anyway, Mr. Chairman, I will not anymore argue with Attorney Topazio with regards to the jurisprudence regarding Senate vs. Song. But in the proper time, just in case, we can talk about it. And when in fact, pati na yung balag, pwede natin pag-usapan, no? Balag case. But anyway, Mr. Chairman, ganito lang po. Kasi the legal counsel of of Pastor Kibuloyesk asking for a reconsideration. Is that correct?
We are asking for time to explain, Your Honor, because as the rules state, the failure to appear must be without legal justification. So we are willing in whatever time allotted to us, Your Honors, so as to obviate any suspicion that this representation is delaying. Actually, ayoko nga pong ma-delay. May lakad po kami nakaproot ng visas ko next week eh. Pero as kung kinakailangan po ay isakripisyo po natin yon. Ngunit, I also understand the misgivings of the Honorable Johnny Pimentel that indeed, these hearings have been going on for quite some time. But ang akin lamang po, Your Honor, is perhaps the committee would rather err on the side of constitutional rights rather than expediency. Yun lang naman po ang aking humble appeal sa chair at saka sa mga miyembro ng committee ito. Salamat po.
Mr. Chairman, actually, question of the appeal of the lawyer. Pwede naman po, pero pwede naman po na lagyan natin ng kulatilya that will cite Pastor Kibulo in contempt. But it will be lifted depending on the cooperation of Pastor Kibuloy because we have done that for the past several contempt orders. But still, Pastor Kibuloy will be cited in contempt in today's hearing.
We will always bow, as I said, Your Honor, to the discretion of the Honorable Committee, of course, subject to my humble reiteration of our appeal, Your Honor. Thank you,
Tapasio, the chair recognizes.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Yes, before I call the next interpreter, the chair recognizes the presence of Juan Carlos Arjo Ataide of the 1st District of Quezon City. Welcome, Kong Ataide, and our deputy speaker, Christine Sigson Mihan of the 3rd District of Ilocos Sur. Welcome, ma'am, to this hearing. The Honorable Jude Asidres. The Honorable
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Franz and
so, di na po natin papakinggan yung ano no, yung alibi ni Attorney Topacio. Nasabi na po. Pero marami na pong ano no, marami na pong pronouncement si Pastor Kibuloy in media na hindi talaga siya dadalo sa anumang mga hearings sa ano no, sa Kongreso. So narinig na po natin yun. Kaya tama po ang ating colleague na parang nagde-delay na lang, magde-delay na lang yung ginagawa. Tapos mahalaga po yung mga question kasi with the development ngayon, Mr. Chair, di ba? Yung pinapasa niya, yung stake niya sa KOJ kay dating Presidente Duterte. So kailangan nating malaman yun kasi may kinalaman sa ownership, which is our topic nun sa SMNI. Kaya kailangan niya talagang pumunta rito at hindi pwede yung sinasabing tatlo na magsasalita for him. Kaya kailangan niya umapir dito, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. The Honorable Judah Sidre of Tingog Party List.
Mr. Chair, I would tend to agree with Mr. Topacio if this were a blue ribbon committee hearing. Unfortunately, this is a committee hearing that centers on the continuance of a privilege of a franchise given to SMNI. And the testimony of Pastor Apollo Kibuloy, given being part of the original franchise, is material to the discussion. And I think this is no longer a question of rights, Mr. Chair. This is a question of duty that by accepting the granted privilege, SMNI is compelled to carry out. That includes Pastor Apollo Kibuloy being one of the grantees in the earlier franchises given to SMNI. And therefore, I will join the Honorable Suarez in seconding the motion of the Honorable Pimentel, Mr. Chair.
Honorable Attorney Topacio. We'll pray on that.
Levity aside, Your Honors, with all due respect to the good Congressman Asidre, the ruling of the Supreme Court applies to all hearings, either of the Senate or of the House of Representatives. Secondly, with respect to the appoint of the good Congresswoman Franz Castro. The same is well taken, actually, Your Honors. As in fact, in the case of Senate versus Ermita, the Supreme Court said that the questions and the proposed legislation should be attached to the subpoena. The proposed legislation is already public, so that is out there, Your Honors. But perhaps, Representative Castro, if we could be furnished proposed questions, and if these questions cannot be answered by the three representatives here, and we are invoking this with all due respect, based on the doctrine of Senate versus Ermita, then we can determine, and then, well, Your Honors, if the legal justification provided by Pastor Kibuloy is not sufficient in the eyes of this committee, then, of course, it may proceed according to its rules. But in the meantime, again, we apologize for taxing the patience of the committee. We, again, humbly appeal for due process in this case, Your Honors.
Thank you very much, Chairman. The Honorable Karap.
Anyway, binuksan na rin yan ni Attorney Topacio. Anyway, yes, iba ko sa yung circumstances with regards to Senate and Ong. Kasi si Ong dumalo eh. He was not given due process. Etong case ni Pastor Kibuloy, hindi siya dumalo. He disrespect this committee. And yung question of legal excuse by attending this committee, okay, I will grant it to you, Attorney. I will grant it to you. But hindi ko sinasabi na tama ka. But we can also impose letter F, undue interference. We can impose undue interference, not letter A.
Well, Your Honor, as I said, we will always submit.
Kaya nga eh, kasi you defended it with our colleague here. Yes, ayaw nga pag-usapan dapat eh. Sabi ko, gusto ko pag-usapan natin sa gilid eh, pati yung balag. Kasi you invoke Ong in which the circumstances is different. Because Ong attended the hearing. Magkaiba yun, Attorney, di ba?
That's why I raised...
That's why, Attorney, ako ayaw, we will end this debate with regards to your appeal. Ako nga, sabi ko nga eh,
Opo.
Pwede naman yung reconsideration eh. Contempt and lifting of the contempt, it all depends on the actions of Pastor Kibuloy. Diba? If he cooperates with this committee, then so good. We can lift that, you know, that contempt. But if you will invoke those jurisprudence, wala tayong... yun na nga yung Ong eh.
Yes, Your Honor.
Iba yung interpretation.
That is why, as I said, Your Honor, we submit always to the discretion of the committee. And there is really no desire on the part of this representation to debate. We're just stating what we feel to be the rights of my client, as it is my duty and obligation as his lawyer, Your Honor. We have no quarrel with the committee. As I've said, the committee will do what it has to do under the rules. We just want to make this humble appeal, Your Honors. That is all. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Yes.
And Representative Paduano.
Yes, thank Mr. you very Chair. Much. The Honorable J.J. Suarez is recognized.
Attorney Topacio, can I just ask?
Yes, Your Honor.
Why does the good pastor refuse to come?
He, to be candid, Your Honor, to this committee, he is apprehensive that his rights may not be respected because of the frenzy surrounding the investigation, Your Honor. And besides, Your Honor, he said that if they ask me and I do not know, there are other people who know about the information, then it might be futile for me to appear before the committee.
I think that's the very problem, Attorney Topacio. He's assuming something that has not yet happened. Throughout the whole series of hearings we've had, I think the committee has been handling themselves properly, legally, giving all the resource persons due process. So I don't think any rights would have been violated if he presented himself. Number two, to assume that he does not know the answers to the questions, when in fact he doesn't even know the questions yet. is false to hold on to, because I myself have questions to ask to the good pastor. And I believe the person that he has sent might not be of the position to answer my questions, because they were not present in the SEC documents. Their names were not present in the SEC documents that were submitted to the Committee on Franchise. So how can that obligation be passed on to them? So again, I'm asking, on numerous times that he has been invited, why does he not come?
If I may respond to that, Mr. Chair, may I respond, Mr.
Yes,
Chair?
Please, you.
Yes. Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chair. First of all, Your Honor, that is why precisely we are asking for a general, not a detailed line of questioning, but just the general questions under Ermita, Your Honors. Number two, Your Honors, we agree with the committee, but Your Honors, please, with respect to the points raised, with all due respect, Pastor Marlon Acobo has been mentioned since 1922 in the submissions to the Securities and Exchange Commission, because in the 2022, Your Honors, because as far back as that time, he has been appointed as the new executive pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ with respect to the day-to-day affairs of recent vintage, Your Honor. With respect to the others, Your Honor, there are other officials of Swarasug and SMNI who are here, Your Honor.
Thank you very much, Attorney. Yes, Mr. Honor. Chair, yes, I think we're treading on very dangerous waters, because this will be setting a precedent to future hearings that will happen in the House. If we allow this, therefore, anytime in the future when a resource person does not feel the need to present himself, magpapadala na lang ako ng tagapagsalita ko. I-submit nyo na lang muna yung mga tanong ninyo, i-review ko, tapos saka tayo bumalik sa usapan. That's a very dangerous precedent to set, Mr. Chair. Because once we allow that, therefore all committees will allow that. Therefore, all committees will allow resource persons not to present themselves. Therefore, all committees will allow advanced questions to be forwarded to resource persons before coming to the committees. And that destroys the very nature and essence of having committee hearings, where we have to find out and ferret the truth and the information that we need in order for us to come up with the proper decisions to make, Attorney Topacio.
Yes. Well,
so that's just my point, Mr. Chair, no? So tungkol po doon sa sinabi ni Attorney Topacio.
Point of order, Mr. Chair.
The Honorable Asidre.
Mr. Chair, I would like to inquire lang in what capacity is Attorney Topacio, with all due respect, Attorney Topacio is addressing the committee. Is he here as counsel to Pastor Apollo Quiboloy or counsel to the KOJ?
Attorney Topacio.
Yes, Honorable Asidre. I'm here as counsel for the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, and also as a general counsel of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy, Your Honor. Thank you.
Can you explain when you said I am counsel for KOJC and I'm general counsel for, what is that?
Yes, I will explain, Your Honor.
Yeah, you use the word counsel for one and general counsel for the second, for Pastor Quiboloy.
Yes, I will explain, Mr. Chair.
Yes.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Yes.
The Kingdom of Jesus Christ is a corporation soul under Section 107 of the Revised Corporation Code.
Okay.
So as a juridical entity, it is entitled to legal representation, which is this representation, Your Honor. In all of the legalities involving the Kingdom of Jesus Christ since not too long ago, Your Honor. Now, with respect to Pastor Quiboloy as an individual, I advise him on general facets of the law, but he has also other counsels with respect to other cases involving him. That is what this representation meant by general legal counsel, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair?
Yes.
I made that inquiry, Mr. Chair, because I would like to ask if the rules of the committee allow for legal counsels to speak on behalf of the resource person, Mr. Chair.
That's a good question. May I ask the Comsec to please provide the rules? Chairman, but anyway, the Honorable Karaps is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Chairman, under our tradition, we allow if the chair, the committee allows. No, but well, in fact, as of now, we're discussing with regards to the inquiry in aid of legislation. Now, sabi ko, Attorney Tomasio, we're so lenient because this is the first time that you attended this hearing and supposedly you should take in your oath because speaking for on behalf of the invited resource person.
Yes, I will.
And well, in fact, again, if the chairman will not allow you to speak for on behalf of Pastor Kibuloy, you cannot speak. And you cannot, again, it's a debate. If you want, again, that you process of being here in this committee, eh, sabi ko nga, and under our tradition, our internal rules, we allow lawyers to speak if the chair will allow you to speak.
I totally agree with you, Your Honor.
And second, sabi ko nga, napakalinyin pa nga namin because supposedly before speaking, you should have taken your oath.
Yes, I totally agree with you, Your Honor. There is no debate, Your Honor.
Just to clarify the query of our colleague. Thank
I
you.
Totally agree. And I am very thankful for this committee for its leniency, Your Honor. Thank you.
Mr. Chair.
So, before we proceed.
We have already discussed this thoroughly. Lumalayo na po tayo eh.
Anyway.
Ang motion ko, iba na yung mga tanong. May legal counsel pa. Let us first act on my motion.
Yes.
We are already almost 1 hour, but we have not yet acted on my motion.
Thank you very much, Honorable Pimentel. I just wanted to give everyone a chance to speak before a vote is taken on the motion of Patep. And we just like to make it clear that, just to show you, Attorney, as we have seen since November, this has always been the atmosphere. We gave everyone the chance to speak, especially on the side of KOGJC, Attorney Mark, Attorney Rolex was given the chance to speak. So, kung airtime lang po pag-usapan, mas marami po kayo airtime kesa po, no? At kami po ay, kasi yun po ang naging policy, we want to ferret out the truth. Ang problema, may mga tanong talaga na lagi pong sagot sa amin, hindi po kaya sagutin. Kaya po, nag-motion po si Congressman Pimentel. As a matter of fact, just to prove our point, it took me 3 weeks. We gave you 3 weeks for him to appear. We didn't give you 1 week. We didn't give you 2 weeks. We gave you more than 3 weeks for him to appear. No, from the time that the last hearing, usually 1 week lang ho yan. Pinapa-appear na po namin. Ito ho, tatlong linggo ho ang binigay ng committee. And even up to now, you can see the ini-entertain po namin kayo. No, na yun, nanay lang ho kayo nag-appear. Eh, nandito po at nakikipag pinapakinggan ho namin yung sinasabi niyo.
Maraming salamat
po. As far as due process concerned, pagay ko nyo naman, eh, hindi nyo na ho pwedeng, we did not fall short as far as the due process clause is concerned. And on section 13, yes, we were allowing you to speak and counsel is allowed under the rules as long as it's allowed by the committee. At maraming salamat at kayo na hong pangatlong may tanong na po pala ako. Kayo po yes, pangatlong abogado, Attorney Rolex, Attorney Mark, kayo na po. At kayo po ba'y abogado lang? Hindi po kayo director ng KOJC?
hindi po. Actually, I became the General Counsel, Your Honor, of Pastor Kibuloy back in 2021, if memory serves, Your Honor.
Okay.
So this is not my first time to lawyer for Pastor Kibuloy. And of course, again, Mr. Chair, we are grateful for the opportunity. That's why you still get my vote in 2025.
Oh, thank you very much, Attorney Topacio.
Mr. Chair.
The Honorable Gutierrez is recognized. Before we will have to go on a vote soon, just ask yes. Attorney Gutierrez, the proponent of the bill. No?
Yes.
Attorney
Gutierrez. Mr. Chair, just to add to the point, no? Just to for the consideration of the body, because I agree with what Congressman Pimentel mentioned, that the contempt order that we are considering is based could be based on sole absence alone. However, I would just like to add for our consideration as a body that there are still material questions as to 2019, 2020, and 2021,
correct,
which I believe would warrant the attendance. Now, his choice not to attend on the presupposed trend that they already know what we would ask, I would have to share my skepticism, po, no? Because precisely, as I mentioned, we still have material questions during the duration of his being executive pastor. So something lang po for the body to consider. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, the Honorable Arlene Process.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, isa po kasi ako sa mga nag-request, di ba? Na, ano, so rejoinder lang po kay, sa issue ng contempt. Mr. Chair, huwag tayo pumayag na by substitution. Hindi naman talaga natin ginagawa yan, Mr. Chair. It has not been our procedure ng mga nakaraan. Kaya gusto ko lang sabihin, Mr. Chair, no, na itong sulat na pinadala sa committee hinggil sa ating sabina, si Mr. Marlon Acobo, executive pastor daw ng Kingdom of Jesus Christ, ang siyang sasagot. Mr. Chair, nung nag-usap naman tayo last time dito, sinabi natin hindi talaga yon kakayanin sagutin ng mga representatives na pinadala. So, Mr. Chair, again, I will join our DS sa kanyang motion. And Mr. Chair, again, maraming salamat kay Honorable Johnny Pimentel for motioning for the contempt of Pastor Apollo Kibuloy.
Thank you very much, the Honorable Arlene Brosas. The parliamentary status is that there is a motion by the Honorable Johnny Pimentel, duly seconded by the Honorable J.J. Suarez, the Honorable Jude Sidre, the Honorable Franz Castro, and the Honorable Arlene Brosas, and of course, our Senior Deputy Speaker, the Honorable Don Gonzalez. That being the case, there is a motion, duly seconded. Any objections? The chair hearing no objections, on a unanimous vote, the Honorable Pastor Kibuloy is cited for contempt. We now proceed to the interpretation. So that being that, we now proceed to the interpretation. Can we now discuss the Marvick? So we will now proceed to another subject matter. And this is the House Bill number 9710. Comsec, please read the bill. The title of the bill.
House Bill number 9710, introduced by Representative Ramon Rodrigo L. Gutierrez, titled An Act Revoking the Legislative Franchise Granted to Suarasug Media Corporation, operating under the business name Sunshine Media Network International, repealing for the purpose Republic Act number 11422, entitled An Act Renewing for Another 25 Years the Franchise Granted to Suarasug Media Corporation under the Public Act Number 8122, entitled An Act Granting the Suarasug Media Corporation of the Philippines a franchise to construct, install, operate, and maintain for commercial purposes radio and television broadcasting station in the Philippines and for other purposes.
May we request the author, the Honorable Ramon Rodrigo Gutierrez, for House Bill number
9710.
Yes.
Mr. Chair, although we've already that this representation already sponsored this bill, may likewise again move that my explanatory note be adopted as the sponsorship speech for this bill. Thank you, Chair.
We now proceed to discussion. Any questions, Honorable Manuel?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I'd like to ask a few questions to our resource persons. Mr. Chair, tanong po sa KOJC. Dahil ngayon, di ba, merong executive pastor na siya ay siya din yung tinuturing na head ngayon ng Aswarasug. Am I correct, Mr. Chair?
Mr. Chair, can I answer the question of the good congressman, Mr. Chair?
Maybe yes, I'm sorry. The Honorable Mark Tolentino.
No, I'm a lawyer, Mr. Chair. I'm not a congressman. Mr. Chair, the answer of that, Mr. Chair.
Welcome back to the committee, Attorney Tolentino.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. With respect to the question of the Honorable Manuel, Mr. Chair, the executive pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ is not part of the day-to-day operation of SMNI. But of course, with respect to Aswarasug Media Corporation, the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, we consider them as the investor. That's why the subscription of Aswarasug Media Corporation in 2019 started only as 50 million subscription. Now, it's already 650 million, Mr. Chair. So, if I may explain, Mr. Chair, that we furnish a copy of our position paper to all the members of the committee. Our position letter dated today, Mr. Chair, March 12, 2024, Mr. Chair. May I furnish this to the Honorable Committee, Mr. Chair?
Yes, Attorney.
Mark, kayo naman nandito naman kayo simula nung simula, nung latang hearing natin November.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Bakit naman po papadala nyo yung kopya nyo on the day of the hearing sa hapon pa? At agad po yung akin 12:30. Isang 30 minutos. Paano na yung pag-aralan lahat yan?
Now, it is just our position, Mr. Chair. It refers only to our answer in our previous hearing, Mr. Chair. But we put that on writing, Mr. Chair. So, we find it all...
So, you're not saying anything new in this letter? Nasabi nyo na po lahat. Sinulat
yes,
sila.
Yes, yes. This is just a reiteration of our position, Mr. Chair.
Yes. So, this is what this letter contains. Yung tapos mayroon pang kasamang USB.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay,
from the very start, USB. Mr. Chair, since November last year, and this is our position.
But anyway, we will have to validate this against the records of the committee, okay? Kung talaga ito po yung mga sinabi, ito po talaga ang mga ginawa ninyo. The Honorable Manuel, you still have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. So, Mr. Chair, ulit clarify ko, ang executive pastor as corporation soul ay investor siya sa Aswarasug. Am I correct, Mr. Chair?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So, Mr. Chair, can the attorney explain na ano ang function ng isang corporation soul?
When you say corporation soul, I already explained that in our previous hearing, Mr. Chair. That a corporation soul, the head of the corporation soul, he is considered as a trustee of all the properties of the corporation. So today, the head of Kingdom of Jesus Christ is in the person of Marlon Jacobo. He is the trustee of all the properties and he is considered as the head of the corporation. But he is not the owner of the executive pastor of Kingdom of Jesus Christ, but he is considered as a trustee. When you say trustee, pinagkatiwala sa kanya ang Kingdom of Jesus Christ. The real owner are the members of the religious organization.
Mr. Chair, ano-anong properties ang pinag-uusapan natin? Ano-anong properties ito ng KOJC na kung saan trustee ang executive pastor?
I am not the best person to answer that, Mr. Chair. I am just a lawyer or the legal counsel of SMNI. So I cannot answer that, Mr. Chair.
Then, Mr. Chair, we request the legal counsel of KOJC to answer.
May I respond, Mr. Chair?
May I respectfully request that the question be repeated, Honorable Manuel?
Yeah, Mr. Chair, since nabanggit na ang Executive Pastor ay siya ang trustee ng lahat ng properties ng KOJC, I was asking ano-anong mga properties ang pinag-uusapan natin dito?
Mr. Congressman, marami po kasi eh. We will be happy to furnish the committee with a list of the properties, but offhand, I would say properties dedicated to the propagation of the faith. There are houses of worship, places of worship, residences of the workers for the church, and others of a similar nature, Honorable Manuel.
Mr. Chair, maliban sa executive pastor, meron bang iba pang trustee or may similar function sa pag-handle ng ganitong mga properties ng KOJC?
As a corporation soul po, yung executive pastor or elder or basically po, whoever heads the church is the sole trustee and administrator of the properties of the corporation soul, Mr. Congressman.
And sa ngayon, Mr. Chair, again, I clarify, that would be Executive Pastor Marlon Rosete?
Yes po. Marlon Acobo. Si Dr. Marlon Rosete po is the president of SMNI, Your Honor.
Okay. Mr. Chair, thank you din sa mga sagot. Pero Mr. Chair, ngayon doon po ako nalilito. Dahil recently lang ay na-announce po sa media na ang bagong property administrator ng KOJC Properties ay si former President Rodrigo Duterte. Pero Mr. Chair, ngayon we hear no, from the legal counsel of KOJC na ang may task to administer the properties would be the executive pastor. So Mr. Chair, ngayon there are conflicting accounts no? At I think this causes confusion dito sa ating committee dahil kung sa bahagi po nila hindi malinaw sino talaga yung nag-a-administer ng properties, ang dating sa akin, Mr. Chair, parang placeholder lang yung mga taong ito. Yung pagkakaroon ng corporation soul, sino yung nakalagay dyan, it seems na hindi talaga sila yung nagmamanage ng mga properties na dahil yung KOJC ay, yun din naman ay investor doon sa Suarasog na siya ding nagmamanage ng SMNI. Kaya Mr. Chair, I think this opens more questions sa ating committee dahil I think wala namang recent issues na involved si Executive Pastor. Kung merong involved sa marami issues ngayon, Mr. Chair, that would be Apollo Quiboloy. Pero bakit merong pag-transfer ng responsibility from the Executive Pastor as the property administrator to former President Rodrigo Duterte? Nakakalito, Mr. Chair, and I think this compels the committee to go beyond yung labels at kung sino lang yung mga taong nilalagay ng KOJC o ng Suarasog sa kanilang mga official records na pinapasa nila maging sa Securities and Exchange Commission. Yun lang muna sa ngayon, Mr. Chair.
Very briefly, Mr.
Attorney
Chair.
Tupacio.
Yes, very briefly, Mr. Chair. When we say administrator, Honorable Manuel, that is in the concept of trustee of the properties. The executive minister remains trustee. But however, under the general rules of administration in the civil code, or when read together with the provisions of the revised corporation code, of course, the executive minister or the elder or the archbishop, etc., of any religious organization cannot be expected to comply with the spiritual aspect of running a corporation soul, a religious corporation, and the day-to-day administration. And the revised corporation code itself, Honorable Manuel, states that there may be schemes in order to assist the trustee in administering. Therefore, the short answer is that the executive minister remains trustee, but in running the affairs of the...
Point of order, Mr. Chair. Point of order. Mr. Chair, point of order. Yes, I'm Mr. Chair. Point of order. Yeah. Kasi kanina ba, Mr. Chair, we have resolved na siya na yung sasagot for Pastor Kibuloy kasi nag-explain na siya eh, yung tungkol doon sa trust, yung pag-turnover ni Pastor Kibuloy kay former President Duterte. At hindi pa siya, Mr. Chair, ang council ba pwedeng magsalita for Mr. For Pastor Kibuloy? Hindi po na resolve yun kasi yes. Kung ganyan po ang nangyayari, Mr.
Chair. Chair allowed already.
Yeah, so can we have
Pasho?
Him
yes.
Take his oath.
May we ask Attorney, kayo lang po, Attorney Topacio, kayo lang po. Attorney Topacio lang po. Okay. Attorney Topacio, please raise your right hand. Comsec, please administer the oath.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth before these congressional hearings, I help you, God?
I do.
Okay, thank you.
And another question, Mr. Chair. Is his taking of oath as representative or general counsel of Kibuloy waive already
No.
The client to answer questions
no,
here.
No, kasi no, no. Ano po tanong nyo?
So, ibig sabihin po ba yung pag-oath at pag-testify po ni Attorney Topacio ay wini-wave na natin?
Yung po?
Pagpunta ni Kibuloy dito?
Hindi po. We've cited him so, in contempt and we'll be asking for that he
okay.
be...
Okay, so gusto lang po nating malinaw yun. Ano? Kasi ang tanong po kasi ni Honorable Manuel po ay yung tungkol dun sa pag-turnover po.
Yes, he'll be asked to appear
okay.
by the committee.
So hindi
and
po,
a proper motion will be entertained later. In a while. Yes,
okay.
Thank you.
So hindi po yung sagot ni Attorney Topacio yung sasagot dun sa
opo.
Mga tanong
because
natin.
Because marami po. Pong
yeah, okay.
Dapat sagutin si Pastor Kibuloy as explained earlier. Now, hindi po lahat masar. Kundi nga ho nasagot
yes,
na Attorney Rolex tsaka ni Attorney Markian.
Yeah, and in a proper time, Mr. Chair, I will also move to invite then former President Duterte kasi siya yung in-involve as o pinasahan ng property.
Okay.
Mr. Chair, in proper time po. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Okay, so next, any other member?
May I proceed,
the
Mr. Chair?
The Chair will recognize the Honorable Jose S. Aquino II of the 1st District of Agusan del Norte, the Honorable Jonathan Clement Abolos II of Fort Peace. He's here. Oh, welcome. And the Honorable Antonio Ferrer of the 4th District of Cavite. Just so that everyone know that I've already signed the attendance in this committee for the plenary. So yeah. It has been forwarded already to the majority floor leader. The Honorable Manuel.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Shortly, Mr. Chair, given din, I think many of our fellow members would also want to ask. Mr. Chair, kung i-replay po natin yung sagot kanina ng legal counsel, malinaw po yung naging tanong ko at yung sagotin po niya ay task ng executive pastor acting as corporation soul yung pag-administer no, ng mga properties ng KOJC. Pero ang nangyari, Mr. Chair, ngayon mula dun sa executive pastor na wala namang kinasasakuntang issue ngayon, ay nalipat po yung task niya sa dati pangulo. Kaya Mr. Chair, again, no, that brings more questions rather than answers sa committee.
Mr. Chair.
Thank you very much, the Honorable Manuel. Yes. Anyway, is there another question?
May I make the clarification, Mr. Chair, about the question of...
Maybe Attorney Topacio, can you because hindi po na, maybe can we also rise so that yes, Attorney Ambrosio.
Mr. Chairman, may I also respectfully request that Executive Pastor Marlon Acobo be likewise sworn in because
please.
This is his first time also, Your Honor.
Yes, please.
Please raise your right. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth before this congressional hearings?
Thank you very much. Okay, Attorney Ambrosio.
As to the clarification with regards to the question of Congressman Manuel, so the scope of the appointment of former President PRRD is only in case of incapacity, disability, retirement, and other inability of the executive pastor and the board of administrators. So this is the appointment was made by the current executive pastor and the board of administrators that in case something might happen, the former president PRRD will be able to manage the properties of the KOJC.
Ambrosio, this is contingent to if something happens to whom?
To the executive, current executive pastor and to the board of administrators.
Who is the executive pastor?
Pastor Marlon Acobo.
So if something happens to Pastor Acobo,
yes,
then President Duterte
may take over to manage the properties.
Will take over.
Yes.
Okay. Because doesn't Pastor Acobo, doesn't he, wala ba siya assistant na pwede mo take over?
This is, Your Honor, this was a management prerogative. It was the discretion of the executive pastor and the board of administrators that we will entrust the management of the properties of KOJC to former President Rodrigo Duterte.
If anything happens to, when you say anything happens, physically, may mangyayari po sa kanya?
This pertains to any inability, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you very much.
Mr. Chairman? Mr. Chairman? Yes.
Honorable...
Yes, I have a question to Pastor Executive Mr. Acobo. Ilan taon na po kayo?
I'm 58, Your Honor.
Yeah, you look very fit. Si former president, ilan taon na po? More or less.
79.
Kasi Mr. Chairman, if I may, kasi meron po akong friend na you know, may edad na 60 plus, nagkaanak. Okay? So yung mga kumpare niyang kinuha, may age bracket siya, ka-age niya, kumuha siya ng mas bata. Ano bang ibig sabihin dito? Ibig sabihin dito, yung mas bata and healthy, that can take care of yung son. So yung sa akin, I'm just wondering lang, bakit mas may edad na yung will can take over? Ano ba naging basis lang po natin dyan?
Your Honor, pwede bang mag-bisaya lang ko, no? Kasubuo na ako ang pag-sulti para ma-express na ako akong gustong isulti. Naman siguro tayo mga congressman din nga makasabot po sa akong isulti.
Oh. Dali lang po. We will need a... Kasi kailangan natin interpreter ho niyan.
Medyo nakakaintindi naman ako kahit papano. Okay.
Ang ibig niya sabihin, Mr. Chair,
okay.
He is not well versed in Tagalog, so he will need somebody to interpret what he will be saying.
Okay. Who would,
Mr. Chair, can I act as interpreter of Mr. Marlon Acobo?
Okay. Attorney Mark, you will interpret sentence by sentence.
Okay, Mr. Chair.
I can also interpret for him.
Inani manggut ang hemtang, Your Honor. No?
Situation, Your Honor.
Senator, Congressman Pumarin. Nga nung gipili na mo si former President PRRD
na mahimong
administrator sa Kingdom Properties despite sa iyahang edad?
Bakit pinili namin si
ang,
PRRD?
Ang point ni mo, Your Honor, is ang edad.
Patapusin mo ito.
Bakit meron po kayo interpreter.
Okay.
Kaya kailangan pinili namin si PRRD.
Pastor Acobo, please address your answer to the chair, not to the member of the committee.
Sorry po. Thank you. Bakit pinili namin si PRRD despite sa kanyang edad?
Tungod kay si former President Rodrigo Duterte, taas ang iyahang eksperyensya, lawyer siya, labaw sa tanan, suod siya ng higala sa Kingdom Ministry.
Si PRRD, taas yung kanyang experience, abogado po siya, then malapit na kaibigan siya sa ministry.
muna ang reason, Your Honor.
Yun ang dahilan.
Thank you very much, Pastor and Attorney Mark. Maraming salamat. Okay.
Mr. Chair?
Yes.
Related lang po dun sa tanong.
Yes.
So is former President Duterte a member of the KOJC? At ano yung naging role niya po sa KOJC in the past and after, present?
Your Honor, dili siya member. Pero ang iyang stand sa Kingdom Ministry is more than a member. Tungod kay ang iyang respeto sa ministry, taas kayo. Sukat pa sa sinugdan.
Hindi siya member ng ministry, but yung kanyang respeto at stand sa ministry is more than a member.
Okay. We will recognize the Honorable Paduano. Then we will now go into we will proceed with further interpretation. The Honorable Paduano.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just to clear the previous motion and was approved with this committee with regards to the contempt order, Mr. Chairman. We should have a second motion. And with that, Mr. Chairman, I move that we direct the Sergeant-at-Arms to coordinate with all enforcement agencies, particularly the PNP, to bring Pastor Kibuloy in the House premises. So, Mr. Chairman.
There's a motion by the Honorable Carapes Paduano. Any second?
Second.
Seconded by the Honorable J.J. Suarez, the Honorable Pimentel, and the Honorable Senior Deputy Speaker Don Gonzalez. The Chair in objection, the motion of the Honorable Paduano to ask the Sergeant of Arms to directing the Sergeant of Arms to bring Pastor Kibuloy to the House premises is hereby approved. We now proceed to the interpretation.
Just a follow-up.
The Honorable J.J. Suarez.
Insofar as the good attorney Topacio is law-abiding and has taken this oath as a lawyer, and insofar as you are going to see the good pastor tomorrow, maybe you can aid the Sergeant of Arms in the exercise of their duty. Hindi, kasi makikita naman kayo bukas, di ba?
Well, with all due respect, that would be a conflict, Your Honor. I hope you will respect the lawyer-client relationship.
Oh.
But I can advise him accordingly, Your Honor.
I was just, under the impression that, of course, you being a lawyer and this being a lawful committee hearing, and what we did was within the bounds of law, you might want to extend your assistance in the exercise of the duties of the committee.
Yeah, Your Honor, I believe that the this committee or the House of Representatives is possessed of sufficient power to enforce its orders even without the assistance of this humble representation. But as a lawyer, of course, I will always advise my clients in accordance to my training in the law, Your Honor. That
Thank you very
I can
much.
Assure the Honorable Committee. Thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you very much, the Honorable Ferdinand Topacio. Okay, any other question that any other
Mr.
member
Chair.
May have before we move for the maybe finally decide on this resolution. The Honorable Migs Ugrades is recognized. Attorney Migs.
Mr. Chair, just for the clarification of everyone, tama po ba na yung nakita po kasi natin sa news yung whole administrator. So right now, it's not in effect. Just to be clear for the body and the public that hindi pa administrator, Mr. Chair, yung pag-a-appoint po.
Yes. Expressed by Attorney Ambrosio, who was under oath, that he is not yet the administrator as we speak, and it is contingent to anything that may happen to
Mr.
Acobo.
Mr. Chair, if we could just have a copy of that also so that the committee will have a copy of which whatever would happen since yung executive pastor naman nandito and there's an appointment pending, if we could have a copy of the document for the said appointment, Mr. Chair.
Attorney Ambrosio.
Your Honor, we will submit.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair, to SEC lang for the clarification of this process. Ano po ba ang proseso ng pag-appoint ng administrator pagdating sa corporation sole? Since it's a different kind of corporation, it's a special kind of corporation na ang executive pastor lang naman ang mag-a-administer ng mga properties and manage for on behalf of the members of the religious sect, Mr. Chair.
That's addressed to
the SEC.
SEC, you may reply.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. To address the question of Honorable Nograles, when an entity incorporates in the SEC as a corporation sole, in the articles of incorporation, they will already specify who is the executive pastor or the elder or the rabbi or the chief of that corporation sole. That's
Mr. Chair, with regard to appointing of an administrator, should the executive pastor be incapacitated? What is the process, Mr. Chair?
Per our record, with regard to KOGC, on December 16, 2022...
Sorry, Mr. Chair, I'm just asking for a general process, with relation to the KOGC, Mr. Chair.
A letter of appointment will be issued by the current executive pastor to his successor.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Just to remind, since we're talking about the laws and the corporation code, given the gravity of what is happening with the media and everything, with regard to section 111 also of the revised corporation code, para lang umiwas po sa mga violations, Mr. Chair, in any encumbrance, selling, disposal of property by an administrator, executive pastor, kailangan po rin po ng court approval dito with regard to that. And I'm just more appealing na sana sumunod po ang KOJC, ang Suarasog, or especially KOJC sa mga ganitong aspeto so that we won't be looking into further violations, and should there be any change, again with the consent also of Congress. Yun lang po, Mr. Chair, just to raise it as a way of reminding lang po the corporations on their procedural aspects para wala na pong, iwas na po sa mga violations na pwedeng mangyari po, Mr. Chair. Thank you.
Honorable Migs Nograles, SEC, please take note of the statement of the Honorable Migs Nograles. Thank you. Thank you. So, any other member that would like to speak for or against this measure? You have now the Honorable Gutierrez.
Yes, Mr. Chair, sorry, before we proceed, just a few questions. Like I mentioned, we had some material questions that were left unanswered in the previous deliberations, and we'd like to take a crack at the theory of the good attorney Topacio that they might be able to answer, Pono. So with the indulgence of this committee, may I proceed with my interpellation of the executive pastor?
Yes.
Mr. Chair, may I request that perhaps is the attorney Ambrosio capable of translating for Pastor Acobo? Yes. Okay, Mr. Chair, so that to keep it within KOJC, you know, while we no doubt appreciate the interpretation skills of the good attorney Tolentino, we would like to have a separate po, no, but we're not confused where KOJC ends and where SMNI begins. So, Mr. Chair, may I ask the good Pastor Acobo, through the good attorney Ambrosio, in your GIS papers, may we begin, how long have you been with the KOJC?
Your Honor, nagsugod ko sa pakikuban kong pastor since 1985.
Your Honor, nagsimula po ako since 1985. Kipagsama kay pastor since 1985.
Mr. Chair, I noticed the good pastor does not need a translator to understand my question. But
nakasabot ko.
Okay.
Okay, Your Honor, pero
you understand. You cannot express
ang akong gustong isulti.
You would prefer not to express in another language, or you are unable of expressing in another language?
mas prefer ko nga musulti og Bisaya, Your Honor.
He prefers to answer in Cebuano.
It is a preference. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chair. Just for the record. So, Mr. Chair, I'd like to ask the good pastor, no? So, since 1985, but his appointment as executive pastor was on what date specifically?
Nagsugod ang ako ang pagkahimong executive pastor, Your Honor. At tong time nga gipil apan na nako ang mga papers para sa Securities Exchange and Commission.
Nagsimula akong maging executive pastor nung pinirmahan ko yung mga papers for the Securities and Exchange Commission.
That was December 19, 2022. O pagka sunod na tuig, January 4, 2023, giaprobahan sa SEC ang pagkahimo na akong executive pastor.
It started in December 19, 2022, and on January 4, 2023, it was approved by SEC. Your Honor, may I make a clarification? So what Pastor Marlon is pertaining to is the amended articles of incorporation, since corporation souls are not required to submit general information sheets.
Okay, so we're now referring to the KOJC, Mr. Chair. But for the appointment, because by the way, thank you, Pastor, for attending today. You know, we would have hoped that you were with us from the start. But we were under the impression, I believe it was one of the representatives of SMNI, that Pastor Acobo took over in 2021. How can we... 2021 daw po yung nala.
2022, Your Honor.
2022, nag-take yeah. over. So the mentioned appointment papers by Attorney Tolentino was based on what? May we ask, Mr. Chair, the representative of SMNI?
Your statement, well, his statement was 2021.
If I'm not mistaken, of course.
Yes. I have with me, Mr. Chair, the certificate of appointment of Brother Marlon B. Jacobo, signed by Pastor Apollo C. Kibuloy, dated December 19 of 2022.
Mr. Chair, may we ask the COMSEC? Yes. If I recall correctly, the previous hearings, it was alleged that it was sometime in 2021. May we check with the records of the, may we ask the committee to provide for the records of with the appointment papers? But probably after na lang po, no? Because there seems to be a, this was very distinct to me.
I think, Mr. Chair, I have to clarify. I was talking about SM and the participation of Pastor Apollo Kibuloy with respect to Suarasug Media Corporation. Because Pastor Apollo Sikibuloy was still a stockholder since in 2019, but in 2020 he is not anymore. In 2020, he's still is a stockholder of Suarasug Media Corporation. In 2021, he's also a stockholder of Suarasug Media Corporation. But in 2022, he already donated his share to Jesus Christ Workers Members Cooperative, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, sorry, just
that's
to clarify.
Why, Mr. Chair, I submitted our position paper today, Mr. Chair, to give emphasis to our stand, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, we would have appreciated siguro po no, yung position paper weeks or days ago so that we can properly understand. The position paper submitted today and the hearing today, of course, we cannot consider whatever the contents are, but rest assured that we will be studying that after today po. No. So, Mr. Chair, so to clarify lang po, no, so according to Executive Pastor, the appointment in JS papers for KOJC 2022 po. The appointment letter, can we have a reading again of the appointment, Mr. Chair?
Okay, Mr. Chair. The certificate of appointment of the executive pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ dated December 19, 2022 at KJC Compound, Field Japan, Friendship Highway, Sasa, Davao City, signed by Pastor Apollo C. Kibuloy to Brother Marlon B. Acobo, Mr. Chair. Acobo.
For KOJC.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So we have to clear with our records for what stood out distinctly was the representation by representatives of FSMNI that there was a transfer in 2021. Because I remember this particularly, Mr. Chair, because we were discussing in GIS. Because
The GS, Mr. Chair, refers to the Swarasug Media Corporation, not to the Kingdom of Jesus Christ.
Yes, Mr. Chair. So, yun po, kasi what's particular to me, Mr. Chair, okay, first and foremost, we'd like to reiterate that the existence of KJC as sole, a corporation sole, is still under question as per the interpellation of the Honorable Nograles as affirmed by the SEC that there were questions as to the two-thirds voting. So we still have yet to receive a report from the SEC on that matter. But that's just to put it on record, po, no, that on question pa. But assuming that we will now proceed with the rules, supposedly, na ito ay corporation sole, Mr. Chair, our question with SMNI is that for September 2020, yun po yung submission ng GIS, and then April 2021, yung GIS, nandun pa rin po si Pastor Kibuloy. And it was both a stockholder and beneficial owner. I would assume that the beneficial ownership of Pastor Kibuloy does not come from his ownership of stocks, but of his influence and control of the corporation, as is per the rules of the SEC. But in the GIS of 2022, as of June submitted, and 2023 as of May, he was no longer stockholder, neither was he beneficial owner, which would make sense for the appointment in December 2022. However, the GIS was submitted June 2022. So on the papers pa lang po ng GIS, wala na po si Pastor Kibuloy. But the appointment was made in December. Kaya how do we explain this incongruency, Mr. Chair?
Pwede ko muhatag o brief history nga nung nahimo kong executive pastor?
Can I give a brief history on how I became the executive pastor?
Oh. Allow that, pero kailangan mo masagot yung tanong, ha?
Oh.
Bakit ho, iba yung sa dokumento, iba yung kinikwento nyo na yun?
Ganito po, inanim ni Your Honor, ang plano ni Pastor na ibiyaan na niya ang iyang pagka-executive pastor.
Ang plano ni Pastor na umalis na sa pagka-executive pastor.
Nag-start ito 2015 pa po.
Okay.
And then, the following year, 2014, tungod kay pagka 2015, na may general meeting kauban sa tanang mga international o national leaders.
In 2015, we had a meeting with the leaders of KOJC.
Gi-announce na ni Pastor na iya nang biyaan ang iyahang pagka-executive pastor.
Pastor Apollo already announced that he will leave his position as the executive pastor.
Ug iya na ning itugyan sa mga board of administrators.
And he will entrust this to the administrators.
Okay. Mr. Chair, very quickly.
2019, padayon sa, Your Honor, pwede kong padayon? Okay. 2019, giingnan ako ni Pastor na ako sa succession plan sa Kingdom of Jesus Christ. 2019, naan ako sa succession plan na ako ang musunod sa iya.
In 2019, I was already in the succession plan.
Na-formalize ni Your Honor ngatong ni pirma ko sa tanang mga legal documents para sa SEC December 19, 2022.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Intention pa rin 2016 kayo na. O 20, bakit hindi ho kayo 2016 o sa 2019 binigyan ng kayo na? Sa mga dokumento, bakit ho sa December, sa 2023 pa pumasok po ang pangalan ninyo? 2023.
Your Honor, tungod kaya ng panahon na ako sa abroad, ang akong assignment nasa abroad, na ako sa Middle East, na-assign, o sa Tibok, Africa.
So, okay.
Tapos na po yung pandemic.
Opo. Klaro po tayo dyan. So, ang hindi pa rin natin nasagot, yung tanong ko ni bakit nagre-reflect pa rin sa SEC documents na yung pangalan po ni Pastor Kibuloy nung sinasabi nyo kayo na. Ngayon sinasabi nyo nasa abroad kayo, nasa hindi pa formal.
Your Honor, maybe Attorney. Ask the question to be repeated so that
Attorney,
it's clear in our part.
There's a inconsistency. I think the question, can you please just answer the question of the Honorable Gutierrez? Why does it reflect that it's still Pastor Kibuloy when he's now saying that it's not anymore Pastor Kibuloy?
Your Honor, if you are pertaining to the general information sheet of Suarasug
yes.
in 2022, it was filed on June 2022. Therefore, Pastor was still the executive pastor at that time. However, he is no longer a stockholder. He is no longer the stockholder of Suarasug because he donated his shares to Jesus Christ Workers Members Cooperative.
Well,
on GIS for June 27, 2022. And the appointment of Pastor Acobo happened on December 19, 2022.
Correct. So, but for the record purposes, there's no show of the transfer because the GIS still shows that this is a Pastor Kibuloy.
Yes, Your Honor. In fact, the amended articles was released or approved by SEC on January 4, 2023.
Correct.
Yes.
So that's what we have on record yes. also. So it still doesn't answer why is it the name of Pastor Kibuloy still there when in SEC, it's so as far as we're concerned, for the entire year of 2022, it was Pastor Kibuloy.
For the entire year 2022, Your Honor, it was only on December 19 that the appointment of Pastor Apollo was provided or decided by the board.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair, just a point of order.
Honorable,
I don't know if we have it in our rules. I'm sorry if I must write down this point. No, Mr. Chair, the executive pastor was assigned abroad po, no? Perhaps we would appeal again that perhaps he would choose to express himself. I'm sure he's very capable in English. Because, Mr. Chair, for when the testimony, when the you know the we invite our resource persons to get to ferret out the truth, as the SJJ said, when it is being coursed through a colleague and an attorney at that, who has been also inputting her own answers in not as translation, nalilito po tayo kung which were the words of pastor and which are the words of the attorney. Mr. Chair, he did say it was only a preference. Perhaps he would consider expressing himself in a language understood by us all here.
Your Honor, no. Gustuhon man ako. Pero mas ma-express magod na ako ang akong isulti kung akong gamiton ang akong pinulungan. Ay hinaot nga
Mr. Chair with the kind volunteerism of Congresswoman Garin, she has offered to translate before us, no?
Attorney Mark, he might want to translate first.
Mr. Chair,
because it was stated I don't think she was listening. Yeah, Attorney Mark, kayo muna.
Ay gustuhin man niya magsalita ng Tagalog but he cannot express na anong komportable siya niya.
So Mr. Chair, whether or not we would accept, you know, comfort or preference, luckily the Honorable Garin has offered. This might be new for the committee po, no?
Yes.
But if we would accept that as our procedure going on, no? Parang we can separate rin yung testimony ni Attorney Ambrosio.
Yes.
Kasi kanina po may translation sana for Pastor Acobo pero may input naman sa GIS si Attorney Ambrosio just to separate the two.
Thank you. The chair recognizes the other members of the committee, the Honorable Jojo Lara. Who's here? Welcome, sir, of the 3rd District of Cagayan, and of course, the Honorable Janet Garin, 1st District, Iloilo. Meron po ba kayong sabihin before we now, we are, the Honorable Gutierrez.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Okay, and so okay, proceeding now back no, with that procedural question done. Yung tanong po natin dito is because there seems to be a disconnect between the GIS of the SMNI with the appointment of Executive Pastor Acobo and the internal workings of KOJC. Kasi po, Okay, admittedly, let us say in 2019, there were informal plans to have Executive Pastor Akobo take over, and that this only took effect in December 2022. It does not explain for the change of the GIS in June 2022. Kasi po dito, natanggal na si Pastor Akobo. And still, well, another factor, we will ask, natanggal na po dito si Pastor Kibuloy. But still, Pastor Akobo was not inputted there. Kaya nga po yung tanong namin sa SEC, which they said, wala naman pong beneficial ownership portion in the documents received by SEC. So that's another issue that we have po, no? Just to recall, para sa lahat natin, sa lahat sa atin dito, there is a difference in the GIS submitted before this committee and the GIS submitted before the SEC. So the SEC could not also clarify kung ano po yung beneficial ownership. Yes. So going back po, no? Though there were plans for Executive Pastor Akobo to take over in 2019 and this only took effect in December 2022, it does not explain kung bakit wala na po si Pastor Kibuloy in June of 2022. Unless the GIS was already reflecting changes without the proper appointment papers. Mr. Chair, maybe ask the explanation from the good pastor.
Actually, kana nga issue, Your Honor, naamang ko na sa, di ba, sa SMNI, ang GIS. Kana nga panahon, siya pa ang executive pastor.
Okay, the Honorable Garin, we want to translate.
In English or Tagalog? During the time, he was still the executive director. He was still the pastor.
Sa pag-submit, ma'am, Your Honor.
When it was submitted?
June. Sa GIS, June 27, 2022. Si Pastor Apollo Kibuloy, siya pa ang executive pastor.
So when it was submitted, June 27, 2022, Pastor Kibuloy was still the executive pastor.
Opo.
Mr. Chair, then why was he not beneficial owner in June 2022?
Nga nung wa man siya na beneficial owner sa 2022.
Yes, Attorney Ambrosio.
Okay, so Your Honor, Pastor Apollo was not included in the 2022 GIS of Suarasug because he does not control the operations of Suarasug, and at the same time, it was the period wherein KOJC, the executive pastor, would want not to involve itself in commercial transactions. So that's why during this period, all control was given to Suarasug because they have their own board of directors. So that's the reason, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, of course, we'll have to accept that as the reasoning, but it is highly suspect because for the years 2022 and 2023, KJC still had 53.4% ownership, not including the indirect ownership they had through Phoebus, which had 46.2%. So if the reasoning is to divest, I think that would have done through the stockholders. Now, Mr. Chair, the question here, and if that were the case, is it not his being beneficial ownership of 2020 and 2021, in which he was still there, was because he was executive pastor? Therefore, it follows in 2022, when he was still executive pastor, he still should have been beneficial owner. And not only that, after 2022, executive pastor Akobo is nowhere to be found in the beneficial ownerships as executive pastor for 2022 nor 2023. So, Mr. Chair, this only supports what we have been inclined to believe, that there is confusion in the papers being submitted before this committee under Section 12 on reportorial requirements, made worse by the fact that the documents submitted here is different from the documents submitted with the SEC. So it brings to focus again, Mr. Chair, the issue of whether SMNI, this is no longer KOJC, SMNI is faithfully fulfilling its obligation and duties under the franchise, a privilege granted to it by this body, by this August call. Mr. Chair, one question. We'll move on from the GIS portion now. I have a question on Section 4 and 7. Recently, we've come to the knowledge that one of your star talents, independent contractors, was found guilty of indirect contempt. Mr. Chair, may we find out from SMNI if there has been any action on their ethics board ba yun, or remedial board, disciplinary board?
Mr. Chair, I'd like to ask, what is that? Who is the talent? Is
Mr. Chair, see, Ms. Badoy.
Ms. Badoy and Eric Celis, they have their program Kasama Lab, Laban Kasama ang Bayan is no longer is suspended as of today, Mr. Chair.
As of today?
No, since February, Mr. Chair.
Since February, Mr. Chair. So, because
you can check that so through our social, records, even our social media, Mr. Chair, we have no more Laban Kasamaang Bayan on in our social media, and including but of course there is Laban Kasamaang Bayan in rally in Liwasan ng Bonifacio.
Same name, no relation.
No relation.
No relation. It's a branding thing, no, yes. Mr. Chair. Okay. So, Mr. Chair, starting February, wala na po yung Laban Kasama ang Bayan.
Suspended.
Suspended. Kahit sa social media.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Our independent contractors are in no way now working with SMNI.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. So, yun lang, Mr. Chair. Thank you for that answer. Going back po, no? So, just to summarize, because I have now concluded my questioning here. For the consideration of this body, the violations that we have found are on Sections 4 on responsibility to the public and Section 7 for self-regulation in relation to the numerous allegations, indictments, or findings of fake news, red tagging. We're also citing Section 10 on the provisions for sale, lease, transfer of ownership. On Section 11 for dispersal of ownership requirement, Section 10 and Section 11 carry with them ipso facto provisions for their revocation. And Section 12, which was just highlighted today, all the more because we could not get the proper answer on the reportorial requirement. So I submit to this body, Mr. Chair, and I request that we consider my bill that is pending before the body. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair.
Gutierrez.
Can we recognize Mr. Chair?
The Honorable Mark Tolentino.
Attorney Mark Tolentino, Mr. Chair, all the questions of the good Congressman Gutierrez is already answered, Mr. Chair, in our position paper. Can I explain in details, Mr. Chair, by reading our position paper, Mr. Chair?
Attorney Mark, since you've stated earlier that is just a summary of all previous statements that you have made, which is still before the already with the committee, then we have that already on record.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So I don't think you still need more time to express what you have already stated in the previously. But just be rest assured that as far as the Honorable Gutierrez is concerned, it has been remained unanswered and he's still in a state of confusion as far as your answers are concerned. Thank you very much.
Okay, Mr.
Chair. Any other member? The Honorable... Pacho, I'm sorry.
Mr. Chair, I'm just wondering, even surprised, kasi Pastor Acobo was appointed by Pastor Kid Buloy as trustee. Executive pastor. Di po ba nakapagtataka? He cannot express himself in English, in Tagalog. Pero siya po yung chosen one. Ano po very special characteristic o special kay Pastor Acobo?
Ma'am, it's a management prerogative na ni Pastor na siya ang mupili kinsa ang gustong mo mupuli sa iya, ha? Whether makasulti o English o dili.
So it's Pastor Kibuloy's prerogative based on management skills, not dependent on the mastery or the art of speaking either in Tagalog or English.
Thank you, po, Mr. Chief.
Thank you, ma'am.
Proceed. Okay, so are there any other questions for or against this measure? The Honorable Franz Castro.
Chair, yung tungkol lang po sa SMNI, no? So, iba po yung sa KOJC, no? Yung mga trustee doon. And of course, with the SMNI. So, gusto ko lang itanong Mr. Chair dahil ang I mean yung stockholder na KOJC, tama ba? Stockholder ang KOJC sa SMNI. And KOJC, Mr. Chair, is a church, di ba? So church siya. So tanong ko lang Mr. Chair, kung nagbabayad po ba ang SMNI ng tax since ang majority stockholder ay church. So paano po ba 'yan? Siguro sa BIR, Mr. Chair. So siguro ko masasagot po ni Attorney Mark Tolentino kung paano ba yung gano'n na merong component ng church as a stockholder ng SMNI, and then yung SMNI ay in a commercial business, 'di ba? O sa business siya ng broadcasting.
Mr. Chair, it is not the Kingdom of Jesus Christ who is the stockholder of Suarsug Media Corporation, but it is the executive pastor of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, the name above every name. So, under the latest 2022 GIS, Mr. Chair, and also 2023, with respect to the taxes, we complied all the BIR regulations, payment, and we can present that to this honorable body, our income tax return of Suarsug Media Corporation, Mr. Chair. And it is open book. You can ask the BIR whether or not we complied all the tax requirement, Mr. Chair.
Okay, Mr. Chair. So ano rin po ba yung ano no, yung alba yung executive pastor as stockholder doon sa SMNI, Mr. Chair, yung benefits niya from that. So paano po ba 'yon as a major stockholder po doon sa ano,
Mr. Chair,
executive pastor, Mr. Chair.
Yeah, Mr. Chair, if I may, with due courtesy to the Honorable Franz Castro, just a quick interjection, Mr. Chair, if I may. Because SMNI is the business name, but the corporate name is actually Suarsug. So maybe for reference, because it's on the records, if the Honorable Castro will be amenable, all her reference to Sunshine Media Network International earlier be changed to Suarsug Media Network International.
Your Honor, may I answer for the question of Honorable Castro? So as to KOJC, aside from being a stockholder of Suarsug, KOJC is also a block timer. So we broadcast spiritual programs through Suarsug. And in case there will be income, dividends may be declared and may be distributed to KOJC as a stockholder. But as of record, there are no dividends declared since based on the decision of the board of Suarsug.
So, Mr. Chair, linawin ko lang. So, ibig sabihin, so walang kinikita dito yung KOJC doon sa SMNI.
As of the moment, Your Honor, KOJC has not received dividends from Suarsug.
Well, Franz Castro, any other question by any other member? If there's none, another question, the Honorable Johnny Pimentel.
Mr. Chair, this is already the fifth hearing that we have conducted. And six? Okay. So, anim na hong hearing ang ginawa natin dito. We have already heard all sides pertaining to this subject matter. We have discussed thoroughly all the pertinent provisions of Republic Act 11422. We exhausted already all arguments that needed to be discussed. And Mr. Chair, of the six hearings that we have conducted, this committee, I believe, was able to establish violations of Suarsug to their franchise. And may I repeat what has been stated by the author, Representative Gutierrez. First and foremost, we have seen or we have established that they were in violation of Section 4, responsibility to the public, which we have already thoroughly discussed, which I will not discuss anymore. Section 10, the sale, lease, transfer, grant of usufruct or assignment of franchise. We were able to establish that there was a change of ownership from Kingdom of Jesus Christ. In 2020, they reported in their GIS that KOGC owned 95% of Suarasug. However, in 2022, as per their GIS, the shares of KOGC was diluted to 46% and it was transferred to Phoebus Global Holdings, I believe. So clearly there was a transfer of ownership, and under Section 10, they should report this to Congress and or rather ask permission from Congress. And once the transfer is consummated, they should report it to Congress within 60 days, which they did not do. Now, under Section 11, we have also established that they were also in violation of this pertinent provision, dispersal of ownership. It is very clear that in the life of their franchise, they should offer to Filipino citizens at least 30% of its outstanding stock. However, for the past 29 years on which they have been operating, not a single stock has been offered to Filipino citizens. And lastly, Section 12, which is the reportorial requirement. So, Mr. Chair, klarong-klaro ho, although, of course, the legal counsels of Suarasug will oppose our findings, they have their own interpretation also of the law, but I believe that this committee has found sufficient grounds to revoke their franchise. On this note, Mr. Chair, this representation would like to move for the approval of House Bill number 9710, an act revoking the legislative franchise granted to Suarasug Media Corporation. So move, Mr. Chair.
There's a motion. Approval of House Bill 9710. Any second?
Second the motion, Mr.
Duly seconded by the Honorable Pancho. Any objections? The chair in objections. House Bill number 9710 is approved as with no amendments. May I suspend the hearing to direct the committee secretary to prepare the committee report. Session suspended. Take your seats.
You might want to go for
the committee report. Shalom. Okay, session resumes.
Mr. Chair, I have in my possession the draft committee report on House Bill 9710. So again, on this note, Mr. Chair, I move for the approval of the committee report. So move, Mr. Chair.
There's a motion. Duly seconded. The chair's objection. Committee report is... There's a second. Second by the Honorable Pancho. Second by the Honorable Ferrer and the Honorable Aquino. The Honorable Manuel. The chair's objections. Committee report is adopted.
Mr. Chair,
I think the Honorable Tontine has something to say.
Hopefully, Mr. Chair, before you will make any voting, Mr. Chair, I'd like to request a time or chance to explain our side, Mr. Chair. And before you consider your voting, I'd like to request all the members to just read our position paper, Mr. Chair, and consider our position paper, because in pursuant to the due process clause, Mr. Chair, give us chance to explain and consider also our position paper before making any voting, Mr. Chair.
Well, thank you, the Honorable Tortino. The vote has already been...
I know, Mr. Chair, that's why it's useless for me.
The vote has already been casted. And there's an approval. And we take note of your request. But I just like to inform you, because of... You submitted your position paper 30 minutes before this hearing.
That's why, Mr. Chair,
we had no time to distribute all of that to all the members. So after this hearing, we will be giving all members a copy of position paper that you wrote, which is basically a summary of all everything that you said in the previous hearings, as you manifested earlier.
Mr. Chair,
kayo po nagsabing lahat yun nasabi nyo na eh.
Our position paper will become useless if you have no, you admit, Mr. Chair, that you have no more time to study and make a voting. That's why I'm asking, before you vote, Mr. Chair,
but
at least 1 week, Mr. Chair, to give all the members a chance to read our position paper, Mr.
Chair.
Attorney Wade.
If I may.
Yes, 30 minutes before this hearing started. I mean, let's be also fair, because there's no way for us to be able to distribute and for all members to study that. First of all, your position paper was just basically things that you already said in the past. So we've taken note of that.
Our request, Mr. Chair, is based on the due process clause of the Philippine Constitution, and we believe the franchise of SMNI is still protected by the due process clause of the Philippine Constitution.
Definitely. That's why six hearings. We said five. You corrected us earlier. You said it was six hearings, not only five hearings. Thank you for the correction. And I think that is already very clear as far as our wanting to give this process to observe due process in this particular hearing. Pagi ko naman po, November pa ho natin pinag-uusapan, Marso na po na yun, ang dami na po natin pagkakataon, i-submit po lahat yan. And it is sad to note that you submitted this document to us 30 minutes before this hearing.
Mr. Chair.
Which we find truly unfair.
We submit to the sound discretion of this honorable committee, but we still stand with our position, Mr. Chair.
Your stand is requested. Your stand is noted. And we request that the COMSEC be directed to submit and distribute all those documents which were submitted 30 minutes today, 30 minutes before this hearing. Thank you.
Mr. Chair, a very short
manifestation. Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair.
Honorable Janet Carin.
Yeah. Mr. Chair, for the information of Attorney Mark Tolentino, believe with the permission of the fair and the chair and the august body, the position report, the position paper can actually be submitted to all members of Congress. Anyway, after the committee report, this will still be tackled in the plenary. And for that reason, Mr. Chair, I believe there is still ample time for all members of Congress to review the position paper as submitted by the legal counsel of SMNI. So with that, Mr. Chair, I believe it will be fair for everybody
to pursue the line of discussion that the Honorable Chairman was earlier stating.
Thank you very much, the Honorable Karin. So again, I direct the committee secretary to please submit and furnish all members of this committee and of course our House Secretary a copy of their position paper for distribution to all members. Maybe a hard copy and a soft copy should be given to them. Thank you. The Honorable Attorney Tomaso.
Mr. Chair, thank you again for this opportunity.
Yes,
Mr. Chair, very briefly, while recognizing the powers of this committee to hold a person in contempt, may I make a final appeal, Mr. Chair, to defer the implementation of the contempt order until after I have advised my client. That is a very humble request from this representation. Just a few days, and maybe we can submit something to clarify our position. And then if it's still the pleasure of the body to continue with it, and then we will abide by it, Your Honor. Just a deferment, not a revocation of the order of contempt, Your Honor. Just a few days, if this committee can find it in its hearts, Your Honor.
Mr. Chairman.
Honorable Paduano.
And what do we expect in that 3 or 5 days? What do we expect?
As I intimated to this honorable body, because I cannot lie to it, I'm under oath, I will be seeing my client tomorrow and I will try to advise him with respect to the order, Your Honor. I will give it my best good faith effort, and I say this not only under my oath before this committee, but under my oath as a lawyer and as a member of the Philippine Bar. Thank you, Your Honor.
So the day after tomorrow, we will expect you and the Pastor Kibiri to be present in Congress.
I will advise him.
Yeah, yeah. But what I'm saying is that will be if you ask me about the consideration, that will be the requirements for us to defer.
Well, of course, I cannot with respect to that, I cannot speak for the good pastor. But Your Honor, I will be seeing him and I will be advising him accordingly, Your Honors.
Attorney Topacio, let's make this clear.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, so we will, 5 days. So
yes, Your Honor.
5 days from now, if we do not hear from you, then we can now implement.
Yes, Your Honor. Whether, whatever the result is, out of courtesy to the chairman,
yes.
I will seek an audience with the honorable chairman to report to him,
okay.
Your Honor, as a matter of courtesy.
So there's no, yes, thank you very much. Anyway, so there's no withdrawal, no deferment. All we're asking is the implementation. So, kung pwede, we wait for 5 days, we hear from you. I think that's the request, huh? I think let's be clear as to
Your Honor. Mr. Jay, to this representation,
yes.
Your Honor.
Mr. Jay, it will be implemented on March 18, that is Monday.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, the March 18 will be the final.
Mr. Chair.
You have to hear before, honor before March 18. The Honorable Pimentel.
This is only a food for thought for all of us. Although it's hypothetical, however, Attorney Topacio might be asking for a furlough, for a 5-day furlough, but we know all very well that Pastor Kobuloy at this point in time is already a flight risk. So baka naman ang humihingi ni Pastor Kibuloy to give time so that Attorney Topacio ay humihingi ng palugit para makaalis na si Pastor Kibuloy out of the country. Hindi po ba, there are already rumors. So, it would be a dangerous precedent on our part. Yun lang, Mr. Chair. I think dapat pag-isipan natin to our colleagues, if you give 5 days, he can easily... we know that Pastor Kobuloy has a fleet of planes. Anytime, pwede siyang umalis. Unless, of course, that we issue or we request a whole departure order from immigration, considering that we have already issued a contempt order and there is already a request for a search warrant, or rather an arrest warrant from the Sergeant of Arms, and then there is a pending again subpoena or contempt from Senate. So dalawang chamber ito, hindi po natin mahalis yung Attorney Topacio that at this point in time, si Pastor Cubuloy, nag-iisip na rin niya na tatakas. Kaya hindi na nga nagpapikita. Even sa social media, he issues statement incognito. So, yun lang po ang dapat pag-isipan po natin, Mr. Chair.
Po hearing natin. Pwede po ba, after your hearing tomorrow, can we hear from you?
Nasa Davao po ako. I'll be back on Thursday, Your Honor.
Yeah, but...
Mr. Chair...
I can call, Your Honor.
You can call us. You can call us when? On Thursday.
Yes, Your Honor.
Today's Tuesday. Yes, Your Honor. You meet with him Wednesday. Thursday, you can.
Mr. Chair, but
at the latest Friday, Your Honor. I'm sorry.
Yes, Tony Topacio said earlier that he will be meeting with Pastor Cubuloy tomorrow. So why will we give him 5 days? Siguro pinagamalan until tomorrow.
Okay, we'll give you up to Thursday.
Your Honor, with respect to the apprehension that he will be pleading, there's already a lookout bulletin, Your Honor. Issued, directed from the DOJ to the immigration.
Okay, so, that's why. And maybe we can also say that if he wanted to really leave, he would have left already.
Yes, actually, Your Honor, I was about to say that. Thank you, Your Honor.
Okay.
Your Honor, could you give me at least until Friday?
Okay, we will give you the deadline with the permission of the move-on and those that have seconded. Do you have any objections to giving him up to Friday? If there are none, then therefore your request is granted that the implementation will commence after Friday. On Friday.
I will personally call on the Honorable Chairman to report.
Yes. And if you wish to write the committee a letter, you may be feel free to do so.
I thank you, Your
and
Honor.
If you can do it early than Friday, it will be much appreciated.
Yes. Not later than Friday.
Yes.
It would be earlier, Your Honor.
Yes. Thank you very much.
We appreciate the gesture of the committee, Your Honor.
Okay. Thank you very much. Okay. So that is clear that the contempt charges stay, but we will give them 3 days after his one-on-one meeting with Pastor Cubuloy in Davao.
Thank you very much,
Thank
Your
you
Honor.
Very much.
Mr. Chairman,
yes.
I move to adjourn.
There's a motion to adjourn. Duly seconded. The chair no objection. This session is adjourned. Thank you.